Hey guys, welcome to another episode of LJ's Garage, and behind me is a 2003 Ford F-250. Ford makes it and International shakes it, so stay tuned, we're going to talk about why this used to be the go-to work truck. And if you're a big truck guy and you're interested, I did another video on a 2008 F-250 with the V10, and the owner of that same truck is actually the owner of this truck, so let's find out if it was an upgrade or a downgrade. If you don't know what I mean by International shakes it, I'm talking about International, the same company that makes the semis on the road and all of that good stuff. They even make military grade vehicles like the MRAP. If you don't know what I'm talking about, here's one. With that being said, you would figure that International knows how to make some pretty awesome motors. So this is no different. This review is gonna be a little different because this truck is loud as heck. It sounds like a jet engine, so I'm not gonna do too much while driving, but I'm gonna show you guys around the outside, show you some interior bits, and then give you my opinions on what it's like to drive this F-250. Honestly, as far as looks go, there isn't a whole lot to talk about. You either love the look of work trucks or you don't, so there's no difference here. This was actually one of the first trucks to actually have tow hooks on the front, and I think that's a pretty cool touch to have these trucks with tow hooks. It just makes a lot of sense. As you can imagine, it's a truck, it's lifted, and it's got some nice wheels on it. You can pretty much customize the suspension, customize the wheels, the tires, however you want on these things. So they're a fun truck to do whatever you need to do to personalize them and make them yours. As you can see this badge, it says Powerstroke V8 Turbo Diesel. And the reason for that is because this does indeed have a 6-liter Powerstroke V8 diesel. And it's got a single turbo, so no Cummins twin turbo, nothing like that. But the reason for the 6-liter is because when originally Ford came out with the 7-liter, due to emissions and all that stuff, Ford had to come up with a motor that could actually meet that, and this one actually gets 20 miles per gallon, and it was able to replace that 7-liter power stroke. As you can see on this badge, it says Ford F-250 Super Duty, and it's got this Lariat right there. Most of you already know that the F-250 and F-150s came in a couple different trims. This one came in 3 trims and a couple special editions. The Lariat is the top of the line, but then you have the XL and the XLT. And I won't even get into the details on those because they don't really matter, because back in the day, we were talking about cassette players, AM, FM, stuff like that, cloth seats versus leather seats and whatnot. So I'm gonna spare you guys the details on those, but just know there's a couple different trims. Lariat is the best. So as far as configuration goes, since we're on the topic, you have 4-wheel drive, you've got 2-wheel drive, you've got Super Crew cabs, you've got all sorts of different cab sizes, you've got diesel motors, gas motors, you've got 6-foot beds, 8-foot beds. Configurations are across the board. Ford has you covered on whatever your work truck needs are. Before I continue this video, I just wanna let you guys know I'd much rather be stroked than rammed. If I were to honestly go with a truck, it would probably be a Chevy, maybe a Silverado. Actually, yeah, a Silverado. I know you guys love numbers, so here it is. This truck made 325 horsepower and 560 foot-pounds of torque. So yeah, it was up there. That was actually the leading truck at the time. In comparison, a Duramax was making 500 foot-pounds of torque and a Cummins was making 460 foot-pounds of torque for that same year. For some more numbers, this truck weighs about 6,000 pounds or so, and it can tow about 12,500 pounds, somewhere in that ballpark. And of course, you can bump those numbers up, make some modifications, and get a lot more out of this truck. One of the major benefits of getting a newer truck is they have step ladders and the little assist bars and everything. For us old guys, it's a pain to get down from here. You've just kind of got to, and you know, your knees, they're not what they used to be. It's a process, man. As you can see, cab and a half, there's just enough room for an average sized person. I wouldn't put someone much taller than 6 foot tall in here for very long. Unless you really don't like that guy, then throw him back here. As far as some quick mods that you can actually do on these trucks, you can do an EGR delete, a tuner, an exhaust, intake, quick mods like that that are pretty affordable, easy to do. And these trucks can actually make some real power. Now this truck actually has a lot of those things done. I won't say exactly what, just in case you run into this truck on the streets, but listen to this exhaust. It is aftermarket. As far as the interior goes, standard Ford F-Series, you know, layout from that era. But wait, what is this right here, you might be wondering? That's right, this is a 6-speed manual transmission. 3 pedals, the best way to enjoy one of these diesel motored F-250s. As I said before, this truck has some modifications, so yep, that is a tuner right there. So we got a couple different tunes, we even have one for fuel efficiency. And if you guys haven't seen a triple pedal truck, here it is. They are real, they do exist. Some of the common problems that I've seen doing some research on these, is the head bolts. That's a common one. The EGR valve, and then the EGR cooler. A couple other things, you've got the oil pump failures, you've got sticking injectors, but all that stuff, again, isn't too difficult. If you go to a dealership, it can add up, can be pretty pricey, but these trucks are pretty user-friendly. They're easy to work on as far as someone that is relatively mechanically inclined. Unfortunately, like I said, this truck is so loud that it makes it really hard to film while driving. So I'm just gonna tell you guys a couple key points about driving it. The transmission shifts pretty nice. The clutch is pretty smooth. Engagement point feels right. If you've ever driven any of the manual trucks, you know exactly what I'm talking about. This one's really no different. It's got a low gear, which you have to use, you know, I like that more than first gear, but that's my personal opinion. It's got a 29 gallon tank, so be prepared to pay a little bit when you fill up. Let's see what else there is. The suspension on this is in stock, so it's a little bit different on every truck you get in. You can customize it, you can change it. So again, I'm not gonna give you guys my personal opinion on this truck. It is what you make it. You tune it how you want, you build it how you want. These trucks are pretty affordable now on the used truck market. So have fun, get out there, get wild. Plenty of forum help, plenty of all that stuff. So my opinion wouldn't really make too much of a difference for you guys, but I gotta say that I do enjoy driving this truck. It's fun having the manual transmission and that 6-liter motor with this tuner. It moves, so be careful, Mustangs. These trucks will come for you. Thank you guys so much for checking out yet another video in LJ's Garage. Be sure to hit that like button, that subscribe button, and let me know down below what you Ford guys, Chevy guys, Dodge guys think about these 6-liter diesels or the Power Strokes, whatever your thoughts may be. And if you're interested, be sure to again check out that other video I did on the 2008 F-250 with the V10.
I love the way this thing sounds. It sounds like a jet engine.